Garfunkel the Flying Cat. Long ago and on a Boeing plane, a cat named Garfunkel got his wings. This gray tiger-striped cat that was owned by one Steve Smirnoff, one of the heirs to the Smirnoff alcohol fortune. Along with a huge fortune, he made hold the cat record for number of hours aloft. On August 19, 1972, Garfunkel was placed aboard a Northwest Orient 747 in Oshkosh, Wisconsin on his way to join his owner. At the time, Steve was the public relations director for Alaska Methodist University in Anchorage. But when the plane arrived in Alaska, the cat's cage was empty and Smirnoff feared the worst, that he had seen the last of his pet. But passengers and crew of the Boeing plane kept hearing meows coming from the walls and overhead as the jet traveled on to the Orient. The pilot even sounded the alarm and radioed back to Alaska. He said, and I quote, "I think our plane is haunted by that guy's cat." It's unknown if he was joking and what was said from the radio tower. But the plane flew on to the Orient. As the plane made its stops from the Orient, it flew to Chicago, New York, and many other places. The plane would stop overnight and the crew would hear the sounds of a ghost cat filling the metal tube it now called home. One of the cleaners discovered that the cat must have found a way out of his cage, and then went into a small narrow passage in the cargo space. Garfunkel was finally lured out of his hiding space in the fuselage by canned cat food and airport hot dogs. By this time, the high-flying cat had logged over 100,000 miles during his 25 days aboard the aircraft. If Garfunkel had anything to eat during his time on the plane, Northwest personnel can't figure out where he'd found the food. At last report, the plane-loving cat was in Everett, Washington, until he finally took one more trip to Anchorage. This brings up the question, what did the cat eat? Stay paranoid, my friends.